So we're going to need a learning algorithm that is more robust to non-linear separability or non-linear non-separability. Does that sound right?
Non-linear separability.
Non-linear separability.
Non,
yeah, I think
left parenthesis, linear separability.
There
right
you
parenthesis.
Go. That's right, negating the whole phrase. Very good. So, and gradient descent is going to give us an algorithm for doing exactly that. So what we're going to do now is think of things this way. So what we did before was we had a summation over all the different input features of the activation on that input feature times the weight, W, for that input feature. And we sum all those up, and we get an activation. And then we have our estimated output as whether or not that activation is greater than or equal to zero. So let's imagine that the output is not thresholded when we're doing the training. And what we're going to do instead is try to figure out the weights so that the not thresholded value is as close to the target as we can. So this actually kind of brings us back to the regression story. We can define an error metric on the weight vector W. And the form of that's going to be 1/2 times the sum over all the data in the data set of what the target was supposed to be for that particular example, minus what the activation actually was, right? The activation being the dot product between the weights and the input. And we're going to square that. We're going to square that error. And we want to try to now minimize that.
Hey, Michael, can I ask you a question?
Sure.
Why 1/2 of that?
Yes. It turns out that in terms of minimizing the error, this is just a constant and it doesn't matter. So why do we stick in 1/2 there? Let's get back to that.
Okay.
Just like in the regression case, we're going to fall back to calculus, right? Calculus is going to tell us how we can push around these weights to try to push this error down, right? So we would like to know, how does changing the weights change the error? And let's push the weights in the direction that causes the error to go down. So we're going to take the partial derivative of this error metric with respect to each of the individual weights so that we'll know for each weight which way we should push it a little bit to move in the direction of the gradient. So that's the partial derivative with respect to weight wi of exactly this error measure. So to take this partial derivative, we just use the chain rule as we always do. And what is it to take the derivative of something like this? If you have this quantity here, we take the power, move it to the front, keep this thing, and then take the derivative of this thing. But that's so this now answers your question, Charles. Why do we put 1/2 in there? Because down the line, it's going to be really convenient. The 2 1/2 canceled out. So it's just going to mean that our partial derivative is going to look simpler, even though our error measure looked a little bit more complicated. So so what we're left with then is exactly what I said, the sum over all these data points of what was inside this quantity here times the derivative of that. And here I expanded the A to be the definition of the A. Now we need to take the partial derivative with respect to weight wi of this sum that involves a bunch of the w's in it. So when we don't match the wi, then that derivative is going to be zero because the changing the weight won't have any impact on it. The only place where this changing this weight has any impact is at x sub I. So that's what we end up carrying down, that the summation disappears, and all that's left is just the one term that matches the weight that we care about. So this is what we're left with now. The derivative of the error with respect to any weight, w sub I, is exactly this sum, the sum of the difference between the activation and the target output times the activation on that input unit.
That looks exactly like, or almost exactly like, the rule that we used with perceptrons before.
It does indeed. What's the difference? Well, let's write this down. This is now just the derivative, but let's actually write down what our weight update is going to be, because we're going to take a little step in the direction of this derivative, and it's going to involve a learning rate.